If you ask a hipster, the word hipster has pretty much lost all meaning. But if you ask someone else, it means hipster, and everybody gets it. Hey there, friends. Grab your fancy coffees. I'm Trace. Thanks for watching D News. Slide into those skinny jeans, grab the deepest V you got, and hop on your fixie, because we are going where everyone seems to go, down hipster lane. Hipsters are difficult to describe as a group, but we know one when we see one, right? And a new mathematical neuroscience paper explains why that is. The hipster effect, when anticonformists all look the same, focuses specifically on French hipsters. Their results found that hipsters, they can't even hipster. Seriously, according to their math, which looks like this, hipsters are too slow to change. And the reason all hipsters look alike is because they are all part of the mainstream pretty much right away. The paper says because the hipsters are too slow to react to new trends, they continue to make the same choices, a la wearing a beard, dark rim glasses, plaid, which maintains a correlation to each other and thus the opposite of a contrarian culture. Essentially, hipsters become a group on their own. A separate study in the Journal of Consumer Research in 2010 found that normally people don't just purchase products, they purchase the emotion behind those products too. So buying a Jeep, you'll feel rugged, or Lululemon will help you feel powerful in the gym or something. Hipsters, on the other hand, purchase things that run counter to their emotional interests, like PBR. Their study says that hipsters are confounding for marketers because they purchase things that they actually hate, then subconsciously convince themselves that they are not part of the trend that's bad. It doesn't reflect who they really are, man. According to Psychology Today's report on the study, the essence of being a hipster is pretending you aren't one. Which is super interesting if you think about it, because this new math study sort of vogues with their assessment. The researchers also determined the ability of a hipster to see the trend of wearing plaid or a beard or something is more difficult the closer they are to another hipster. For example, two people in the same friend group won't see themselves as alike, because even though that they're both wearing vintage high school sports team t-shirts they got of Goodwill, a stranger at a coffee shop would notice it right away, and they wouldn't. The further you are from the system in question, the easier it is to spot the correlation. Plus, the science of the hipster isn't just limited to clothes and trends. There's also huge music scenes associated with counterculture. A service called Priceonomics used data from Facebook in Congress with a music blog called Pitchfork to determine how underground and therefore hipster a band could be. It was pretty accurate for 2013. Bands like Sun Kill Moon and The Field were considered very hipster. They had lots of critical acclaim, but very few shares and mentions on a giant social network, Facebook. While Vampire Weekend was only a teeny bit hipster because people shared it way too often, way too pop culture, guys. Justin Timberlake, not hipster in the least. Science, yo. Trends exist throughout pop culture, and because hipsters buy a lot of stuff, researchers are looking at their habits and social structures. Interestingly, hipster is thought to be someone who attempts a specific counterculture. But in reality, it does fit more with the dictionary definition, a person who follows the latest trends and fashions, at least according to this math study. So with that, I say the V-neck mustache combo is just the 20 teens version of the starter jacket, or parachute pants, or big feathered hair found in other decades. It was counterculture for a minute, and then everyone started doing it, so it wasn't anymore. The counterculture becomes the culture so fast, according to mathematics, that people can't adapt quick enough. In the end, people who try to fight a trend are copying other people and are therefore part of a trend. Are you a hipster? Say it, be proud, go ahead down in the comments, let us know. If not, just tell us your favorite hipster spotting story, because we've all got one. Go ahead and subscribe to D News while you're at it, and thanks for watching.